As corruption continues to take a toll on service delivery in the country, anti-corruption agencies are doing everything possible to reverse strategies. In this aspect, the State House Anti-Corruption Unit, in collaboration with the National Debate Council, NDC, have decided to take corruption fights to schools in order to enroll new fighters to the cause.
We value our young people because, one, we appreciate that our population right now is 70% youthful, and we need to engage these young people from an early age to take the anti-corruption message to them.
Israel Ochoa, the director of legal affairs in the State House Anti-Corruption Unit, says they have to deploy different strategies for different age groups in order to tame corruption that is taking turns, especially in government agencies.
And this corruption problem is mostly among those of us who are old, all the older generations. And what are we saying? We'll use the investigation and prosecution for those already involved in corruption whom we may not redeem to create that deterrent effect. But for the young, we cannot use investigation and prosecution on them because they are probably not in offices and they are still at the stage where we can mold them.
Under this program, the National Debate and Speech Championships was organized at Parliament under the theme Deepening Transparency, Accountability and Anti-Corruption Among Young People. Schools competed in debate and poems about anti-corruption, and Parental Care Primary School Bushenyi won the primary category, while St. Mary's College Chisubi won the secondary schools category.
We believe that appointment-based student leadership is the one that should be used in order to reduce this corruption. How? We want to use appointment-based student leadership because, first of all, appointment-based student leadership does not involve corruption such as bribery.
Students choose bad leaders because they are friendly to them. Secondly, students choose bad leaders because these leaders bribe the students. The third answer, students choose bad leaders because these leaders whom they are going to choose are incompetent.
They are leaders who are honest, transparent, accountable, responsible. Our dear judges, you are seeing that.
We spoke to young people and they shared what they can offer to the fight against the corruption, which is a monster claiming over 10 trillion of public funds every financial year.
That is to engage in fighting corruption, and it is important because my role as a citizen is to promote development in the country by fighting corruption.
I engaged in this thing because I just love entering stuff that can help me to express myself naturally, and which when there's still an advantage taking place.
This competition encourages us to show our skills. Okay, there's a way it teaches us to become confident.
Gusta Kakaide, the chairperson of the National Debate Council, says they have refocused the fight against corruption to the young people because the elders have proven to be a disappointment to the country.
Because the young people are the majority and because they are young and will be here longer, we think teaching them that corruption or stealing from the state is stealing from themselves is going to bear results.
Currently, three ministers and one official of the office of the Prime Minister are battling cases of corruption before the anti-corruption case for sharing relief iron sheets which were meant to benefit the people of Karamoja.